On board the aircraft carrier Charles de Gaulle, the combat planes have been catapulted into the air nearly every day for almost 3 months now, on the attack against Colonel Gaddafi's supporters in Libya. And while no one at the operations level is willing to make assessments about how effective it has all been, there are growing political questions about the lack of participation by some allies and the cost to those who are participating. Especially since one of the unstated goals of the operation, getting rid of Gaddafi, still seems distant. But monetary costs aside, some of which the military argues would be run up with regular training anyway, the real costs are less tangible. For one thing, there are the human ones. Because of a previous deployment, the Charles de Gaulle, Europe's only aircraft carrier, has been at sea 220 days over the past 10 months, far beyond normal duty.
Yes, for sure, for the family it's hard. Nobody can say that they're not missing their family, but we are here to do our job, so we're going to do it as long as it needs to.
Pilots like Luxor, who are not allowed to use his real name, will tell you, too, that there are plenty of Libyan soldiers still out there, despite the months of bombing. In fact, the admiral commanding the French fleet says that he's surprised at the tenacity of Colonel Gaddafi and his forces. It was perhaps a sign of growing impatience with the Libyan situation that earlier this month, the French and British deployed helicopter assault ships to raise the pressure on the Libyan leader. The French military commander says that just because there are now helicopters operational off the coast of Libya does not mean that planes are being used less. In fact, they're flying as many missions as before. And therein lies an issue that the French military chief of staff points to, that the longer the Libyan action goes on, the more the French military is, as he puts it, eating away at its potential. He estimates, for example, that if the Charles de Gaulle stays at sea until the end of the year, it will have to undergo a major refit that could last through 2012, something the carrier's captain is not worried about for the moment.
This ship is a nuclear aircraft carrier and of course needs some maintenance, but by now I don't have major concern about that. I hope that Gaddafi will resign before.
So the helicopters have been brought into play not to replace the aircraft of the Charles de Gaulle, but to further protect civilians and tip the balance toward Gaddafi's departure. If that doesn't happen, one further military possibility is suggested by what's stowed in the rear of the helicopter assault ship, troop landing craft, necessary for the intervention of ground forces in Libya, a possibility no one yet wants to contemplate. Jim Bitterman aboard the aircraft carrier Charles de Gaulle off the coast of Libya.